12 hacks of Christmas. Hack number one, pear Mostarda. Now this is a fantastic thing to do well in advance. It's a perfect little gift. Pear Mostarda is a slightly punchy, fiery, somewhere sits between like a chutney and candied fruit. So it's got that sweetness, it's got the fiery from the mustard. It's perfect with cold meats, with cheeses. It comes from Northern Italy where it's super traditional, especially at Christmas time. There won't be a sort of a meat platter in Northern Italy without a Mostarda of some sort on it. It's that important. Recipes sort of vary throughout Italy, from Tuscany through up to like the northern regions. But I'm gonna show you a really simple one today, which is kind of takes the best from all of them. So the great thing about this, it lasts for ages. You can do it well in advance and it makes great little gifts for Christmas. UK pears are fantastic for this. You can use different sort of fruits, but I think now pears are in season, it'd be a shame not to use them. So we start by peeling the pears. You can use all sorts of fruits for this, but British pears, especially this time of year, are just fantastic. Some I've seen actually, you know, you don't actually cut the pears up at all. You can sort of preserve them whole. But I think it's a lot more easier to eat, a lot more user friendly if you chop them into chunks, and it kind of speeds the process up a little bit. You don't want them to be too ripe either. When you do the maceration process, which I'll talk about in a second, they'll just lose too much moisture and they won't have any texture. So you kind of want them at that stage where you're not quite gonna eat it, you think it needs another day in the fruit bowl, that's perfect for this. Cut the core out, chuck them into chunks. That's the sort of perfect size, in my opinion, for this. As I mentioned in the sauerkraut video, we're gonna do a baker's ratio, so that's 50% of the total weight of fruit. This is much more accurate than other recipes which say 6 pears to maybe 100 grams because you don't know how big the pear is. This way, you weigh the fruit, weigh out the sugar, and you know you're gonna get it spot on. So I've weighed them and I need about 300 grams of sugar. Gonna put it on, gonna mix it through and allow it to sort of macerate in the fridge. So what happens when you sort of macerate something in sugar? It's kind of similar to salt. It will draw out all the moisture and that will sort of firm up the texture of the fruit and allow it to be preserved. I mean, it looks like a lot of sugar, but remember this is a treat, it's Christmas and you're only gonna have a small bit of it as part of your cheese board or your meat board. Now you've got it sort of nicely mixed in with the sugar, you wanna whack it in your fridge and then sort of every sort of 6 to 8 hours, for a couple of days, you want to keep it moving. Don't worry too much, it doesn't matter, it's not strictly important. You just don't want all the liquid from the pears to form at the bottom and the pears at the top to be dry, so you want to keep it turning. And then after a couple of days, all the moisture from the pears will be out. You have this lovely sort of fruity syrup and then we're ready to go to the next stage. The pears have been in the fridge now for about 2 days. I've turned them about 3 times. I should have probably turned them a few more times, but it's Christmas and there's other stuff to do, isn't there? But it looks like they have worked perfectly. They've basically released all this liquid, which has turned the sugar into this lovely syrup. And I've given it a little taste and it tastes sweet. It's like, well, it tastes like pear syrup. It's really, really tasty. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna drain off the liquid. We're gonna reduce it a little bit with white wine and the white wine will give it a little bit of acidity to cut through all that sort of sugary syrup. Next, we're gonna add the mustard powder, as the name suggests, Mostarda. There's a key ingredient. It's got that punchy kick, which comes from the mustard powder and also some black mustard seeds too, which just a little of fiery little balls, which go really, really well with the end product. So I know this sounds quite weird, but if you think about it, mustard goes so well with cold meats and cuts and cheeses as well, and then so does fruit, so does something really sweet. So we've got a perfect combination of both of those things. So really do this, give it a go this Christmas, and these look beautiful. They're a perfect gift. Do a load, give them away to your friends and your family. Now they're in the jar, put them on the shelf, leave them out at room temperature for about 2 days, and then put them in the fridge, and then they'll last for a very long time. Definitely see you through the Christmas period. So there we go, that was our first veg hack of the 12 hacks of Christmas. I really hope you enjoyed it, found it useful, and excited to try it at home. So if you've got any comments, questions, then let us know in the comments section. Hit like, hit subscribe, and follow us, and see what else we come up with. Merry Christmas.